this tutorial, we're going to use the professional edition of the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp to route PVC air and exhaust piping for a direct vent energy efficient tankless water heater. The piping configuration we'll create is based on the installation guidelines provided by the manufacturer. Be sure to check the requirements for your specific water heater and your local building codes. We'll be using SketchUp on an Apple Mac computer. If you're running SketchUp on a Windows PC, the process is virtually identical. The air intake supply line will include a short trap for collecting condensate piped to a floor drain. The exhaust line will vent to an outside wall using a horizontal termination kit. Before we get started, we'll temporarily hide some of the geometry in our model to avoid visual distractions for tutorial purposes. Open the SketchUp Outliner tool, select the gas and hot and cold water pipe groups, right-click the selection and choose the hide option. Launch the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp and sign in to the cloud service. Let's route the air intake supply line. Click the Create Pipe Group tool. Enter a name for the pipeline in the Properties drawer and select the PVC 40 spec. Then select a nominal diameter of 3 inches. Let's adjust our viewpoint a little using a saved scene. Click the Route Piping tool. While the tool is active, we'll temporarily activate SketchUp's orbit and zoom features using the mouse wheel to adjust the view. When the interior of the water heater air intake nozzle is clearly in view, hover the cursor across the face edges and face surface of the connection to encourage the SketchUp inference engine to find the center point. Click the center point position. Drag the mouse till a dashed route line appears. Now, press and release the up arrow key to lock the route leg along the vertical blue axis. Adjust the view towards the horizontal termination kit air intake connection, and hover the cursor across the face edges and surface to encourage the SketchUp inference engine to find the center point. Click the center point position. This will define the vertical leg of the route. Find it and click it again to define the horizontal leg of the route. Press and release the escape key to close the router tool. Next, we'll route the exhaust vent line using the same procedure. Click the Create Pipe tool and enter the appropriate properties. Click the Route Piping tool. Encourage the SketchUp inference engine to find the center of the water heater exhaust vent nozzle connection. Click the center point position. Press and release the up arrow key to lock this route leg along the vertical blue axis. Click the center of the exhaust connection face on the termination kit and click it again. Press and release the escape key to close the router tool. Next, we'll resume work on the air intake supply line to add the trap and condensate drain. First, we need to select the existing group so that the new fitting components we add will become members of the air supply line. We can select the group in the SketchUp Outliner tool. Notice the PipeDraft Properties drawer now displays the attributes of the air intake supply line we created earlier. The condensate trap is assembled from two 4x3-inch concentric reducing couplings and a short length of 4-inch PVC pipe. Change the nominal diameter in the PipeDraft Properties drawer to 4-inch. This will load the component drawers with 4-inch diameter fittings. Click the Reducers component drawer and select the 4x3 concentric reducer coupling. Click a position along the horizontal leg of the air intake supply line for the first reducer and click another position for the second reducer. Press and release the escape key to finish. We'll need to reorient one of the reducers so we can route a short length to 4-inch pipe between them. Select the reducer component using common SketchUp selection techniques. Click the PipeDraft Transform Components tool. Click the SketchUp Graphic window. Then press the left or right arrow key to flip the component about its virtual connection point and positions. Press and release the escape key to finish. Now, let's erase the short length of 3-inch pipe and replace it with a 4-inch pipe. Select the pipe segment component and erase it. Click the Route Piping tool. Click the large end of the first reducer. Then click the large end of the second reducer. Press and release the escape key to finish. Next, we'll route a 1/2-inch drain line along the wall to a position near the floor drain. We'll use a PVC clamp-on saddle O-lit to tap into the 4-inch pipe for the drain. Click the T's and branches component drawer and select a 4x1/2-inch clamp-on O-lit. Click a position along the 4-inch line to locate the component. While the component is still active, press the up or down arrow key until the outlet is oriented towards the floor. Click the Route Piping tool and click near the bottom of the O-lit. Drag your mouse down a little so you can see a dashed route line extending from the O-lit, then click that position. While the Route Piping tool is still active, press and release the left arrow key to lock this route along the green axis. Drag your mouse towards the wall a little until you see a dashed route line extending towards the wall. Enter 5 into the SketchUp measurements box to define the length of this route leg to be 5 inches long. While the Route Piping tool is still active, press and release the up arrow key to lock the route along the blue axis. Drag the mouse downward until a dashed route line appears. We'll temporarily activate SketchUp's pan features using the mouse wheel and the shift key to adjust the view until we can clearly see the floor. Click a position along the wall near the floor. Press and release the escape key to finish. Now, we'll use the SketchUp outliner tool to unhide the other piping and do a final inspection of our model. That completes this tutorial. To recap, in just a few short minutes, we used PipeDraft to detail the PVC air intake supply and exhaust piping for the installation of a direct vent tankless water heater. Please subscribe to the PipeDraft YouTube channel to be kept informed of newly released tutorials on how to use the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp for creating spec-driven, three-dimensional pipelines for your industrial, residential, and commercial projects. Thanks for watching.